everyone, welcome back to the course. We have come to the most important section of this course, the judgment of the horoscope. The concepts, whatever we learn until here, are going to be the foundation for judgment of the horoscope. I would like to mention a couple of important points here. First, the astrological predictions cannot be simply based on strict hypothetical principles. One must use common sense coupled with certain amount of intuition. Secondly, an astrologer cannot make good judgment just by going through the Vedic text. An astrologer should have a strong skills in astronomy, data analysis, history, current affairs, and good philosophical knowledge. So in summary, a good astrologer should have a right mix of profound knowledge, concise judgment, and immense power of intuition. We have learned so many astrological concepts so far, but never ever apply them blindly. Take those learnings and apply them in the modern context. Here comes the most important role in the judgment of horoscope. Never prejudice a planet as fully benefic or fully malefic in a horoscope. Every planet will show the result according to the rulership in the horoscope. There is a beautiful quote from Swami Vivekananda about good and evil. I will read through for you. Please watch it carefully. Good and evil are only a question of degree, more manifested or less manifested. Just take the example of our own lives. How many things we see in our childhood which we think to be good, but which really are evil? And how many things seems to be evil which are good? How the ideas change? How an idea goes up and up? What we thought very good at one time, we do not think so good now. So good and evil are superstitions and do not exist. The difference is only in degree. It is all a manifestation of that Atman. He is being manifested in everything. Only when the manifestation is very thick, we call it as evil. And when it is very thin, we call it as a good. So the point that I would like to emphasize here is, the good and bad are the sides of the coin. When you understand this philosophy, then the judgment of horoscope will become easy. Next, let me tell you some of the important points to judge the strength of the horoscope. In fact, making predictions without understanding the strength of the horoscope may potentially give a wrong judgment. First, the trine houses, that is 1st house, 5th house and 9th house, are the foundations of the horoscope. So in any horoscope, if the trine houses are well placed, then we can confidently say the foundation of the horoscope is strong. Secondly, the Kendra houses, that is 1st house, 4th house, 7th house and 10th house, are like pillars of the horoscope. The strong Lagna Lord is must to operate to the full potential of the horoscope. As mentioned in the last video, even if the horoscope has too many Raja Yogas, but if the Lagna Lord is not strong, then the native will not able to manifest the full results of the Raja Yogas. The Dustana houses, that is 6th house, 8th house and 12th house, should be free from the affliction. Any Bhavadibadi aspecting its own Bhava adds strength to that Bhava. For example, the Lagna Lord aspecting Lagna will add strength to the Lagna itself. The 2nd Lord aspecting 2nd house will add strength to the 2nd Bhava, and so on and so forth. Even if a Bhava is afflicted, the aspection of Jupiter is capable of decreasing the afflictions. Let us quickly analyze the strength of the Steve Jobs horoscope. The ascendant is Leo. First, let us analyze the Trigona house, which is 1st house, 5th house and 9th house. The Lord of Lagna, that is Lord of 1st house Sun, occupies 7th house and it aspects Lagna itself. Remember, as mentioned earlier, a Bhavadhipati aspecting its own Bhava adds the strength to its Bhava. So the Lagna Lord occupies 7th house and aspecting the Lagna itself. So the Lagna Lord is fairly strong. Then the 5th Lord Jupiter occupies 11th house and aspecting 5th house itself. The 5th house is occupied by Venus and Rahu. So 5th Bhava is also fairly placed. The 9th Lord Mars occupies its own house, aspected by exalted Saturn. As of now, we will ignore the malefic nature of Saturn. but we can say that the ninth lord is also fairly placed. Next, we will go through the Kendra lords, that is lord of first house, fourth house, seventh house and tenth house. The fourth lord Mars occupies ninth house, aspecting fourth house itself. The fourth bhava is hemmed between Rahu and Saturn, because Rahu is in this side of fourth bhava and Saturn is in this side of the fourth bhava. But since fourth lord itself is aspecting fourth bhava, the fourth house is also fairly placed. The seventh lord Saturn exalted in third house, aspected by Mars and Jupiter. But since Mars is powerful yoga karaka for Leo ascendant, this aspection is moderate. So seventh bhava is also fairly placed. The tenth lord Venus occupies fifth house, with Rahu aspected by Jupiter, Kedu, and third aspection from Saturn. So 10th lord is also fairly placed. So from this we can understand that the overall strength of this horoscope is pretty good. So we are ready to make the judgment of this horoscope. So let me quickly summarize. The most important point in judgment of the horoscope is that never prejudice any planet as completely good or completely evil. The every planet will give result according to the rulership in the horoscope. We have also seen some of the important points to find the strength of the horoscope. The trine and Kendra house should be well placed. The strong Lagna lord is must. The Dustana houses should be free from affliction. Any Bhava Adhipati aspecting its own Bhava adds strength to that Bhava. And Jupiter aspection is capable of reducing the afflictions. See you soon in the next video. Thank you.